Hey everybody, it's Babette with Haggerty Dog Training, and I hope you all are getting ready for an awesome Thanksgiving. I know I am. I love this time of year. Some of my best memories growing up were Thanksgiving weekend with my grandma and my cousins. So I hope you all are getting ready for a wonderful Thanksgiving as well. What I want to talk to you about is travel safety, going to your destination for Thanksgiving or any holiday or any destination, as well as safety on the day of Thanksgiving, you know, when you have your relatives and friends over. The first thing that I want you to keep in mind is when you are traveling. I remember, you know, going to dog shows with my dad, and we'd be driving, you know, we'd drive from one end of Southern California to Northern California, and that's a long drive. And I would, you know, sometimes the dogs would whimper and I'd say, "Dad, I think they have to go to the bathroom." No, let them stay, let them stay. And I couldn't understand why he was being a big meanie and he wouldn't let the dogs out of the crates to go to the bathroom. But then I realized why. The more times you get the dog out of the car, especially in, you know, a rest area where trucks backfire, cars are blowing by, traffic is at high speeds, people are around, you have an opportunity for the dog to get away from you. So if you don't believe that, I can tell you a long, long time ago in the early 90s, I had two Brittanys that came to me for training, and they would come and do my canine enrichment program. And they were there for several years. And they used to take Valley and Divot. The owners used to take Valley and Divot up to their lake house up in North Florida somewhere. And it was a good like 6 hour drive from where we were. And I remember telling them, I said, "Look, you need to crate the dogs in the car. Do not take the dogs out. Do not stop in a rest area for the dogs. They can hold it. They are capable of holding it and they'll be fine, because you don't want to increase the chances of them getting away from you." Well, the Valley and Divot's owners listened to me. No, they did not. They come back one weekend from a trip and they said, "We should have listened to you." I said, "What happened?" "Well, we took Valley and Divot out of the car. Something happened. They got away from us." There they were along the Florida freaking turnpike trying to get their two Brittany Spaniels. I don't know if they were chasing a bird. I don't know. I don't remember the details. I mean, this was more than 20 years ago. But they were chasing Valley and Divot down the highway, down the Florida turnpike, trying to get them back. Fortunately, they got them back. They didn't get hurt. But they said, "We will never, ever, ever again stop at a rest area with the dogs and take the dogs out." Because all it takes is like 1 second, one goof up, you drop something, you know, you're holding, you know, your phone and your coffee and your keys and everything else, and you drop the leash, and before you know it, the dog takes off on you. So you don't have to stop at every rest area. You really don't. So I also recommend keeping your dogs crated in the car. Now, if you have like a cute little sports car and there's not enough room for your Mastiff in a crate in your like little Porsche 911 or something, then you definitely want to get a harness for them. In addition for the harness and the seatbelt, you want to keep a leash on your dog. Why do you want to keep a leash on your dog? Because suppose the dog chews through the harness. Even if you have the dog crated inside your big SUV, keep the leash on the dog. Why do you want the leash on the dog? Because if, God forbid, something happens and you get into a terrible car accident, and I'll tell you a story on that. You get into a terrible car accident and the dog busts out of the crate, you still have a leash to grab onto the dog. An old dear friend of mine, she was on her way coming back or going to a dog show. She was towing her travel trailer. She had all of her dogs in her van. She got into a terrible accident. The van flipped over, the crates popped open, dogs again all over the Florida Turnpike. Fortunately, she had leashes on the dogs and people were able to like slow down, stop, get out of the cars. And it was a lot easier to grab leashes, step on leashes, than a panicked dog that you have no way of getting them. And they're just that far away from you, at least if you grab the leash. Now, keep in mind though, when you stop at your destination and you go to reach into that crate or you reach in the back seat to take the dog on the leash and take them out of the car, make sure that you grab the leash closest to the neck. Okay, don't reach for the handle, because especially if the lighting's not good or depending where the leash is and maybe under your dog's tush, sometimes dogs will chew on the leash. You wanna make sure you have a whole leash. Sometimes you could grab the handle and realize, "Oh my God, the dog chewed my leash, and there's my dog, and here's the handle to the leash, and it's not attached." So make sure that you grab near their neck as you're taking them out and just feel, make sure that the leash is completely fully attached and they haven't chewed it in half. So you want your dog crated, you want a harness, you want your dog leashed, you don't want to stop everywhere. What else do you need? You need lots of paper towels. Suppose your dog gets sick. Okay. I do recommend when you put your dog in the crate or even on the back seat, get like a couple of towels, like maybe a bed, and do some layers. So if your dog gets sick, all you have to do is like roll up the top towel, put it in a plastic bag. That's the other thing you want, plastic bag. You can roll up that towel, stick it in a plastic bag and keep that. And then they still have more bedding underneath them. So you want your paper towels, you want your plastic bags. I also recommend before you leave for your destination, see where the emergency clinic is, because if you get to your destination and you have an emergency with the dog, you don't want to sit there at 1 o'clock in the morning Googling the nearest vet, and you don't even know where you are. So when you find the nearest vet, you don't even know if that vet is that close to you. So Google the emergency clinic that's closest to where you will be staying. So you want to do that. You also want to make sure that you have like a gallon or 2 gallons of water in the car at all times. Suppose your car breaks down. Suppose you hit a storm. You never know what's going to happen. You don't want to change your dog's water. The other thing you want is you want extra food, so that if you go through more food when you get to your destination, you don't have to worry about finding that same food. So you always want to have extra food for your destination so that you don't have to look for it. You want to have that extra water. The other thing I recommend that you bring is a couple of cans of pumpkin, some chicken broth, and some Minute Maid rice. Because if for some reason you get stuck somewhere, I mean, I know people who they'll travel, they're driving down to Florida, they get stuck in like West Virginia somewhere and the car's broken down and they're stuck in West Virginia for 2 days and they don't even know where they are and they don't even know where the nearest pet store is. At least this way you have pumpkin, Minute Maid rice that's already cooked, and some chicken broth. Okay, if you have those three items, you can really stretch out the food supply that you have. So that's great to always have, like even just having your house in case your dog is sick. You have a snowstorm, you live in Florida, you have a hurricane. Have that in your emergency kit, your bug out bag for your dog. So you want your extra food, you want the extra water, you want your paper towels, your plastic bag, you want an extra leash. Always have a second leash with you in case your dog chews that one leash. Make sure the ID tags are up to date. Make sure your microchip information is up to date with the microchip company. Because if you've moved and your dog is 8 years old and your dog ends up lost and they go scan the microchip and it's like, oh, it goes to like a disconnected phone number 800 miles away, how are they going to find you? So you wanna make sure everything is updated. I also recommend that if you're gonna put your dog in the crate, put like a sign, you know, tape it to the crate that says, in case of an emergency, please call, you know, your mom, your neighbor, whoever it is, that if God forbid something happens to you and you are being taken to the hospital and maybe you're not conscious, that there is a contact number for your dog. Because in a really horrible accident, you know, you're going to the hospital, your dog's in the crate, you know, a nice fireman, a nice EMT guy, woman, whatever, they're gonna be taking out your dog. And generally speaking, what they end up doing is they bring the dog to the nearest animal control. But if there's a phone number, a contact information that the first responders can call, that person can come and get your dog. And that could be like, you know, that dog's guardian for that time. And what you can also do if you're traveling with your dog in the back seat, have your dog's, you know, overnight bag right next to them with that information in case of emergency, like right on top of the bag, you know, pin it to the top of the bag. So again, the first responders, they go into the car, they see there's a dog, you're in the ambulance, like, oh, in case of emergency for the dog, please open. You know, these seem like kind of crazy, one a million things, hopefully nothing's gonna happen. But my dad used to say, prepare for everything and you'll never need it. So I strongly encourage you, you wanna have everything marked in case of an emergency. Have that backup person. You know, what happens if something happens to you? Who can come and get your dog? Who can take care of your dog and knows how to do that? You know, the extra food, the extra bags, the extra water, extra layers of towels or bedding for your dog, the extra leashes, keep them crated. And by all means, you know, have a wonderful, safe holiday. And I hope you enjoy yourselves. And thanks for tuning in. Have a great day.